The G-Spot is a television show in development. The producers of the show have no negative intentions, although they do wish to entertain and enlighten.
Scraps.
Ooh, Wiki likes to eat scraps. Is a Wookiee usually a good dog?
Sometimes. Half the time.
This is our... Here on the G-Spot, we had a contest for the first viewer to email us. We'd come and videotape some stuff at their spot. Well, our first viewer to email us was Wookiee! Say hi, Wookiee. Any pressure?
That's his way of saying hi.
Wookiee, I'd like to ask you some... I'd like to ask you some questions. Wookiee, let me ask you a question. I want to ask you what kind of show you'd like to see on the G-Spot. Would you like to see a church tour show? All right, good. Would you like to see a variety show? Okay. Oh. What about a show called Eckler? Would you like to see an Eckler reality-based game show? Ooh. All right, see, we've done the variety show, the Eckler show, the church tour show. Other shows. The lap dance show. I thought I was spacing a show up. Wookiee, do you want to see a lap dance show?
I think that's a yes.
That's a yes! Thank you, Wookiee! That was precious. What about a cultural show? Would you like to see a cultural show where we go to different art galleries and videotape stuff? Do you like that idea?
Ooh. That's a no.
That's a no. That's a no. Can you say precious? Oh, that's... We should probably give you a treat, but we don't have any. Would you like a beer? Oh, no treat magically appeared. Oh my God, that is precious. That is so precious. Your dog seems to be voting for the lap dance, which I think is great. It's great to have dogs so supportive of such a animalistic kind of event.
Well, it is springtime, Jeffrey, and he is kind of going through his heat stage right now. So that is probably the reason he chose the lap dance.
Do male dogs go through heat?
In the spring, yeah, they have a tendency to get a little more excited sexually than...
All right. Well, Brian, out of the five shows that we've offered here, and the shows in development, what show would you like to see on the G-Spot?
A funny one.
Love you, hate you, love you, when you do, gotta have you. You're a sinner, a whore, you're a sinner. I don't know about you. Say. To settle down with a man of your own, you want a baby, a family, a piece of security. Shut your mouth. Try not to panic. So shut your mouth. Yeah, you can do it, smart girl. Give what you want. Scar. You can go far. Mark. Shut your mouth. Try not to panic. Shut your mouth. You can do it. Shut your mouth. Not to panic. Shut your mouth. You can do it. Shut your mouth. What it takes to be something. Shut your mouth. What it takes to see someone. Shut your mouth. We're gonna, yeah, someone. Shut your mouth. What it takes to be someone. So shut your mouth.
What the heck is this?
Thank you. I spend most of my time dancing, and that's all I need to do. That's all I want to do. That's my desire. That's my passion. That's what takes me where I need to go.
What inspires you to do what you do? Where did dancing begin?
It probably began when I was just an early child, of course, and just music just took me one day, and I just found myself just prancing and dancing all over the house. My mom remembers me as a little boy just, you know, asking her to turn on the radio, and because back then we didn't have MTV, and the music just grabbed me.
So is that still what drives you to this very day, is the music and the feeling that you get?
It's just, you become the rhythm and the power of the passion of the movement. I really don't know how to express this in words.
Yeah.
What happens when you're out there, and that doesn't matter where you are, but you're out there and you're just going on your vibe, dancing, using your feet, using your body, using your eyes, just taking it all in. It's just all about the dance.
What sets your dancing apart from, you know, like ballroom dancing, just normal dancing, like line dancing, or anything of that nature? What sets Dancing Jeffrey's moves apart from the norm?
I think it's a very good question, and I'm glad that I'm willing to address this because part of my dilemma in my life is the how people tax me, and the way that, you know, because I'm not a certain style, I'm not ballroom, I'm not tap, I'm not jazz, you know, I'm not break dancing. You know, I'm Dancing Jeffrey. And basically, you know, it's hard for me to explain, but you know, ever since I was a young child, you know, being it dance music or just music, man, music moves you. You know, it really digs you, you know, and people are so structured that they have to be, oh, I just ballroom, oh, I just tap. And I'm like, man, I just want to move. You know, and so I've took lessons. You know, I've had some influence, you know, in forms of tap, jazz, aerobic, belly dancing, you know, I mean, break dancing in the early 80s. I mean, my God. I mean, it's just taking your body and putting it there. So I'm really not classified in any form.
How many Dancing Jeffrey critics are there out there? Is there anyone who just doesn't like what you're doing?
Oh, there's this guy named John. He's just, you know, he's just a tripping himself. But he, I wonder with him if it's not more jealousy. Because, you know, I am blessed, I must say, that, you know, I'm not obese. Or I'm not I don't want to put John Jant down, because that's not my karma. That's not my aura. You know, I mean, I'm not here to compete with John. You know, John can move how he wants to move, but things John can't move like me. And that's where John doesn't like me.
So who are you in then?
Hey kids, you've been watching the G-Spot, and it's about 9:13, 9:14 on Wednesday night. Welcome. What you've been witnessing here is Dancing Jeffrey, a Tommy Austin short film that features I,
Jeffrey, and crazy John Eckler, who I really want you to focus on and really absorb his energy and really get a grasp of the Eckler, because he might be your greatest ally or your darkest enemy. That sucked. All right, here's the deal. All right, here's the deal, folks. We're watching Dance of Jeffrey, and I want you to really absorb John Eckler. Because John Eckler is the guy you may have to manipulate to keep you on the game, or he might vote you off. I know it doesn't make a lot of sense right now, but the Eckler reality-based game show is coming, and it's going to be a trip. Because John Eckler...
And some people call me Crazy John, because I'm such a great dancer.
That's why they call you Crazy John.
Yeah.
Well, how do you feel about Dancing Jeffrey and what he's doing for the dance community?
I think he's really a joke. He don't know how to dance properly.
Why is that? What's wrong with what he's doing now?
He's not really dancing. I mean, he just...
But he seems to have a lot of feeling while he's doing that.
Yeah, but I mean, there's really no true style to his dancing. I mean, he's just a... track just to show off and get people's attention. That's all he's after.
Really?
That's all he's after.
He's really jealous, and he needs to focus his energy on things that he's really good at.
Yeah. And
dance all over his ass, and I will. I'll show him up any day I need to, but the thing is, as long as he doesn't tax me. And see, John likes to attack me. Yeah. He likes to put me down. He likes to criticize. I've had physical threats by John.
I don't know. It's kind of... I guess I kind of loathe him. I mean, he's really...
Because he's got all the popularity.
Yeah, I mean, he's out there... Basically, not really dancing. He's just jumping around, acting like an idiot or whatever, and trying to show off and get people's attention. That's what he's going for, and that for some reason people
it seems appealing.
Yeah. So I mean, that's really why I don't really care for him.
I mean, I try to. I can rise above.
Yeah.
This little petty stuff.
Right.
But John's my biggest critic.
So you have your enemies, and obviously you probably have your supporters as well.
Oh yeah, we got some groupies.
Okay, my name is Zachary, and I guess it was a couple of summers ago, and I was just hanging out and dancing. Jeffrey just, you know, I turned around and there he was, and we were in the park, and it was. I think it was just kind of fate.
Really?
And ever since then, I mean, I just always try to just to be there and to you know, to witness, because it's like poetry. What I love most about Dancing Jeffrey is just how passionate he is about his dance and it's just him.
Yeah.
Just how he is so full of expression. And the music just, you know, he just becomes one with it.
What's your opinion about these groupies? I mean, do they ever get in the way of your art form? Do they ever hinder you, so to speak?
When they disrupt the flow of movement. Trust me on this one. When they disrupt the flow of movement, and it's not, you know, I love to, you know, I've like I said, I've took ballroom dancing lessons. You know, I can dance with somebody, all right. But when the groupies are on you, it disrupts the flow of the pattern. The freedom of expression that I'm trying to express.
Right.
And if they're just pawing at you, oh, dance again. You know, you're like, please, you know?
Yeah.
If they want to dance with me, you know, feel the flow, I'm all about it.
Right.
some freedom of expression. You know, I'm not going to let boundaries stop me. And, if, you know, and as you will see, you know, if I feel like dancing, I'll just dance right then. You know, I don't need music that's being played. It's in here. You know, and people that know me, it's like this. Either you love Dancing Jeffrey or you hate Dancing Jeffrey. And if you love him, it's because he's free. And that's what you love. If you hate him, it's because you're a slave. That's what it is. You're a slave, and that's why you hate Dancing Jeffrey.
Slave to what?
You're slave because you're not allowing yourself to be free. And you're witnessing freedom of expression.
I see.
I can see where Ava's jeans come from.
Do not tape me. I like my anonymity.
I love this woman. Love her. What show would you like to see on the G-Spot?
A funny one.
Does that mean you'd either see like a variety show?
Yeah, I prefer the variety show, actually. Although You Lap Dancing was a great show and personally one of my favorites.
God. Get it over. Here's the camera. Quick. We gotta get quick. We don't got much time. We gotta get this up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's bad, man. It's bad. It's bad.
Ooh, he's going all out. Now this is cleaning. This is cleaning at the G-Spot. We have to wait 30 full seconds, and then that hopefully will relieve the spot.
The G-Spot?
Not the dirty spot.
So, Brian, tell us what you'd like to see. Just give us your opinion, Brian. Because we they have a call. We thought that might be a really serious phone call for Brian, but it turned out to be a wrong number. What'd you think?
I think you made a mess. But the variety show, on the other hand, it has potential. See, because you have so many different aspects of filming that you could do to bring in different genres and different different class of people, a variety of people of all ages, and you know, I think that's the best way to go in your situation.
Oh, we're gonna cut it. That we're gonna edit that out.
Okay. You know what? Well, you know what we're gonna do also. So we're gonna add this. We can do this shit because we're running out of time with the camera. Bad lighting over here. Okay. All right, guys. It's viewer email time here at the G Spot, and it's time that Jeffrey Michelle reads the viewer email, and I give shout-outs. That's right. If you emailed me, I'll probably give you a shout-out.
All right.
Shout-outs. All right. From this one viewer, he goes, "Dude, I've been waiting for some episodes. I want to see the reality-based Eckler," what we were just talking about. "Dude. Shout out. Your show is funny. Toda. Muffins are oh so good." Muffins are oh so good. All right, next up. This is from somebody called S. Harris 14. And they write, "Please don't ever come to my home." All right, next up is a young man named Max. And Max happens to be a very excited viewer. And Max writes, Hi, this is what he writes. "My is Max, and I watch your show." That's right there. "Hi, my is Max, and I watch your show. It is one of the coolest shows I've ever seen, and I hope one day that I might have my own show on Channel 20. I was wondering if you could give a shout-out to my G Colin. A simple hello would do. So if you email me back, that'd be cool. Thanks, Max." Thanks, Max. Oh. So here's a shout out to Max and a shout out to the G Colin. Shout out from the G Spot, boys. Thank you for watching. Oh yeah, and he goes, "P.S. You should have a show where people get hurt during stupid stuff." Well, Max, if you haven't caught on by now, I do lots of stupid stuff, and I do get hurt emotionally. And here's another email from Max. "Dude, no problem. Your show is the coolest thing that ever happened to me. I like to see a lap dance show, so would my G Colin. I tried calling you, but you weren't home, so I talked to your roommate. I'm going to try to call you tomorrow after school." So this makes you wonder. Max is probably in middle school. But hey, you got to love it when people watch your show. So you're excited when people watch your show. I just wish we had female viewers that wanted to see a lap dance. We're gonna edit that out. We're gonna email you, Max. We're gonna email you back. How about that shout out? How about that shout out? Shout out to Max. G Colin, Max. G Colin. Doing a shout out, Max. G Colin. Alright, give it up one time for Max.
We suck today. I suck. I'm not.
Yeah, whatever. So, this is called On the Fly. This is called On the Fly editing, shooting. It's a duality. It's the contrast. It's the juxtaposition. It's the dichotomy. Sunrise. He's the famous photographer that you've seen do this. Oh, we're having too much fun. What are you looking for?
We love you, we hate you, we love you, we want you, we need you, we wish we were like you. They say you're a saint, you're a whore. you shut your mouth. Try not to panic. Just shut your mouth. If you can do it, shut your mouth. Try not to panic. Just shut your mouth. If you can do it, just shut your mouth.
Please do.